We've got more than 90,000 rowdy fans at Sanford Stadium on the campus of the University of Georgia. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke tastes, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Both teams have sent their special teams onto the field, and we're ready for the opening kickoff. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 26. The Bulldogs and their ground game have always been sensational. It's not always one guy, Herbie. Sometimes they've got two or three that can carry the ball.
And that's what makes it so tough for this defense, is you're not focusing in on just one guy. You're focusing in on really an entire scheme. And because of that diversity, I think it makes it more of a challenge. And you got to be better tacklers in the open field. And I think that's really what they've stressed all week, is tackling and gang tackling and getting to the football.
Hard to get to guys and make tackles in space. Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. He's tackled around the 25-yard line. The screen pass goes nowhere.
Well, you got to take your hat off to the defense. All week, they preached over and over again how they were not going to let this kid use his speed in the open field, and they really shut him down that time.
Going deep. And down he goes around the 33-yard line.
It definitely put them in better field position, and I just have a feeling that they're going to punch it into the end zone on this drive.
Swift gets another carry. He's knocked out of bounds at about the 21.
Very well-designed play that time to give him a first down. The linemen executed their blocks nicely, and it went for a good game.
On the ground, and he won't get back to the line. From the 25-yard line, second down. Looks for his tight end over the middle, and he hits him hard at the 15.
Very solid gain through the air. I'm impressed with the poise of this quarterback and the ability of the receiver to keep his concentration and get his hands on the football.
And a quick throw. Touchdown, Georgia! He splits the uprights with the extra point. A seven-play, 75-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Fred, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
Blankenship has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off.
Is this
from the three. Tackle made at the 32-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. He scrambled. He's wrapped up for the sack. It's second and 13. Ball on the 29-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. Fumble! Defense has it. It's one of the corners. And they make the stop
around the 32-yard line.
They work hard, and they got the turnover.
This is what it's all about. Defense taking advantage of an opportunity. They're pouncing on the loose ball.
They're going to review this fumble, and I've got to tell you, I think he was down before the ball popped loose.
I don't know about this one, Brad. They called it a fumble on the field, and they need indisputable video evidence to overturn this call.
So the booth and the referee agree. The runner's knee was down.
That was still a close call, though, Brad. Even though he was down, this guy has to do a better job of holding that football.
Here's a quick throw. It's picked off. They'll bring him down
around the 40-yard line.
Spectacular play there by the linebacker to come away with that interception.
I don't even think the quarterback saw him on that play. He was right there waiting for the ball.
From the 40-yard line, it's first down. Georgia up 7 points. Knocked out of bounds at about the 35.
Too much on that play, and let me tell you, they didn't have any room to spare because they barely picked up the first down.
Takes it right, and he can't get back to the line of scrimmage. From the 32-yard line, it's second down. Fires that quickly to the tailback. That's a great tackle at the 37. After the sack, it's now fourth and long. Georgia can make this a two-possession game with this field goal. It's up, looks long enough, and he just drilled it from long range. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. And he got off. This one, great kick. He's to the 20. That was a great hit. He wasn't getting away from that one. This one might be coming back, folks. Let's check out the penalty. That one's going to put him way back.
You just can't block a player from behind like that, or it's going to cost you.
We'll have to see now how the offense responds this time after throwing a pick on their last drive.
He can't dwell on the interception. There's still a whole lot of football to be played today.
Throws it in a hurry. He's taken down at the 22. A nice-looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here, and again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
He's scrambling. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. Tackle made
at about the 37-yard line.
This is a pretty tough guy, and he's a great leader. He's going to do whatever it takes to help his team.
Dangerous throw. This one's picked off, and he's taken down at the 36.
That's the last thing they needed to happen was an interception. They're trying to fight to get back into this game, and to have that miscue, now it's really up to their defense to try to help them out.
We've got a first and 10, ball on the 36-yard line.
Mike 56.
Hand off, and he's met in the backfield.
You punk! Mike 17.
down at the 36-yard line. He's looking for his man. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. First and goal coming up. He's knocked out after a big game. And he just gets rid of it. Second down, goal to go. 6 yards to the end zone. And he's tackled right around the 4-yard line. They keep it on the ground with a tailback. Touchdown, Bulldogs. Hits the PAT. A nice 6-play, 36-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. Blankenship gets set to kick this one away. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Georgia's defense really came to play early in this football game.
Well, they've done a good job here early, but you know eventually this offense is going to start clicking. Let's see if this defense can sustain this for the rest of the game.
The offense will take the field, hoping for a better result than their last drive.
One general rule in any game is to hold on to the ball. If you're in the negative in the turnover department, your chances of winning decrease exponentially.
Second down at 14. Ball on the 21. He gets rid of this one.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Delivers to the halfback on the screen. He's tackled at the 24-yard line. That's a 3-yard pickup.
It's a nice play by the defense to shut down all the lanes, so this halfback wasn't able to make anything happen on that play.
They've got 10 guys up. It looks like they're going to try to block this one. Gets to about the 47-yard line. Georgia's on a roll. They've really been clicking in all phases of this one early.
Yeah, when you play a team like this that you know you're physically better than, you just leave no doubt. Take control of the game early and try to dominate, and that's what we've seen.
A touchdown was the end result of their last drive as this offense moved the ball very well with their passing game.
Well, I think this defense has got to do something because right now the quarterback
sends it out quick, intercepted.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line. Gains his way to the 29-yard line. Decent run up the gut. Rose picks up 5 with the carry. Quick pass. And down he goes. Right around the 24-yard line.
Yeah,
gets it out in a hurry. That could have been a big play for the defense.
Yeah, even though he had a good shot at picking it off, it's still a heck of a play to force the incomplete pass.
It's fourth down. They're going to try a long field goal here. He gets it up, and he got it. Well, that one looked like it was going to be wide, but he put it inside the upright.
Yeah, he squeaked that one in, and he didn't have much more than a couple of inches to spare.
Duffy has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. He'll take it from the two. They'll bring him down at the 18. The Bulldogs are punching it into the end zone when they get the chance, and that's been the difference so far in the ballgame.
Yeah, give them all the credit. It's one thing to move the football down the field, but when you get an opportunity to come up with a touchdown, you have to capitalize on it, and they've done that.
They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. And he is drilled at the 28-yard line. Takes it out to about the 36. The PAT. It was a quick three-play, 83-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Well, Brad, right now this offense is hot, and they also took advantage of some mistakes there by the defense.
Blankenship looks ready to kick this one off from his own goal line, and he's tackled at the 22-yard line. They need to show a little giddy up now, because if they don't start eating into this deficit, they could easily fall out of the game. And he's hit immediately. So at the end of one, Georgia in front, 24-3. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. Play action. Now he's on the move. And they make the stop right around the 40. He fights forward to about the 43. It out to about the 44-yard line. Now he's scrambling. They'll bring him down around the 49-yard line. They get nice yardage on that run. Now he tries to buy some time. Now he's going to run and watch out. Tackle at the 32. From the 32-yard line, first down. And he hits him hard at the 24.
Easy.
Scrambling around. They bring him down.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush, because sacks can be real drive killers.
And this is the 10th play of the drive. Fires right side, got his tailback. He's taken down at the 26. Not much there on the screen play. So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board. The kick is up, and he nails the long field goal.
That one looked like cake for this kid. Chalk up 3 points for the offense.
24-6, Georgia. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He'll return it from the one. Tackle at the 30. It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I've got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. Gets out to around the 38. Nice job by the running back, and that'll get him 7, maybe 8 yards. Gains his way to the 46-yard line. Gets out to around the 45.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want none. They don't want none of this.
He gets out to about the 42-yard line. Positive yardage.
Double tight.
Three down. Mike 17.
Swift again. Decent run here, right side.
Two tight.
First and 10. Ball on the 32. They give to the tailback, looking for the corner, and they push him out at the 21. There's a strike complete. Tackle made at the 18-yard line. He's got the corner. Touchdown, Georgia! He splits the uprights with the extra point. A 9-play, 70-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
And, Brad, right now the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big run.
So our score, 31-6. Georgia lines up for the kickoff. He'll return it from the 3. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line.
Every single time this offense has the ball, they're moving the football, but they're settling for field goals. And every time they settle for field goals, I've been watching the defense that they've been facing and watching how they run off the field to celebrate a job well done, because they're not giving up touchdowns. That's a bad sign.
Right. Second down, 10 to go.
Ball on the 26.
He steps up
at about the 29-yard line.
Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. And he's taken down
around the 32-yard line.
Simmons is back awaiting the punt. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. He's tackled at the 28. The Bulldogs obviously have built their offense around this guy. And through two quarters, everything's working, Herbie, but... you know, you can't just rely on one guy, and he's got to be careful a little bit in the third and fourth quarter, too.
Well, you want to keep pushing. I mean, he's off to a great start. This offense is obviously off to a great start. It's a four-quarter game, and, you know, the opponent's going to try to get back into this game, take some chances. So if this running back is smart, he'll continue to challenge himself, his offensive line, and the entire offense, continue to try to put more points up on the board.
Georgia looking to put this game away if they score here. Catches it, and he's looking for more. And he tackles him hard at the 38.
Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
Brought down at the 46. Yard line. It's first down. Caught with room to work. And he's tackled right around the 28-yard line.
This guy has that innate ability to get just enough distance from a defender to make a completion possible. You don't see it from every receiver, but this guy's got it.
Throws complete. He's got space to work. He's knocked out of bounds at the 22. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. The Bulldogs wideout out with an apparent injury, although he might make a comeback before this game's over. Passes to the right. It's picked off. Inside the 10. He's all the way home. Touchdown.
How about the play by the defender? That was a great interception and an even better effort to bring the ball back for a touchdown.
And he converts the extra point. Get set to kick this one away. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 26-yard line. Georgia's been playing like a well-oiled machine in this first half. And Kirk, are we going to see more of the same in the second?
Well, I think as long as they can maintain the proper frame of mind, I think they've got a great shot to be able to pull away and win this game decisively. But the challenge for them will be listening to their coaches at halftime and continuing to play with that same aggressive attitude that they played with in the first half.
Passes left, going the other way. He's tackled right around the 26-yard line.
Brad, not only a huge interception to get the football back and maybe have a chance to get back into this game, but this could really change momentum. You can see the players and how they're responding down there on the sideline about how excited they are to get the football back and have a chance to put points on the board.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 26. Throws it in a hurry. And down he goes at the 17. So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
He's on the run. Slides down to the ground.
I'm telling you, quarterbacks who can run the ball are so hard to stop. You have to scheme around them, which takes the best coverages out of your defensive playbook.
And they make the stop around the one-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. Decides to take it himself, and he's got it. Touchdown.
When you're that close to the end zone, it's always a smart play to find your blockers and follow them into the end zone.
And he hits the PAT. A four-play, 26-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. Across the 30. And the kicker comes in to make the tackle. Their last drive ended with an interception. We're about to find out what the defense can do this time.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
He gets hit out of bounds
at about the 35.
It's second down, 6 yards to go. Ball on the 35. The Bulldogs running back taken out earlier, sidelined with that injury. However, it looks like he's going to be able to come back in this game. They'll bring him down at the 46-yard line.
I credit the quarterback on that pass. He made a great read and delivered a very nice pass for the first down.
Offense lines up in a five-wide set, and the defense anticipating pass here. And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. They hook up over the middle. Tackle at the 42. Finds his man and they take him down immediately. Kirk, that was a nice grab there.
You know, it may be simple, but whenever you can gain solid yardage, you're doing something right.
So with the half ending, they're just going to try to put 3 points up on the board. He gets it up, and he got it. With only a few ticks left on the clock before halftime, I would expect they'll just squib kick this one. It's fielded at the 2. Tackle made at the 26. So we played two quarters. The Bulldogs lead 34-20.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Seemingly an avalanche of turnovers in the first half. You'd think that there would be better ball security in the second half, but if these teams continue on this benevolent path of continuing to hand the football to the other side, who's going to get the edge? What's the most important thing to getting the edge in a game like this?
Well, I don't know which team's going to continue to be a nonprofit and just give the football away. Here you go. You know, here's some charity. I mean, whichever team can put some drives together and not shoot themselves in the foot. I mean, it's really painful because when you do put together good plays followed up by bad ones, that's all you remember. You don't take away the positive from it. So, you know, each team has had some success, but finding that success with some consistency is something they need to do because you got to put a premium on that football.
Looking forward to seeing this second half. I think there's certainly a want for victory.
A want and a need for victory. Some teams need this victory, Reese Davis.
Want, need, got to go get it either way. Brad and Kirk are there to deliver.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. He's got the corner. He goes down at the 50. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. He scrambled. Now he's going to run and watch out. He's taken down at the 30-yard line. And he's level at the 27. Nice run there as they work the outside. And they got him for a loss. So it's fourth down. They're going to try a long field goal here. The kick is away. It's long enough. And he just drilled it from long range. Kentucky gets set to kick this one away. From the one. He's taken down at the 32-yard line. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Knocked out of bounds around the 36-yard line. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line.
Tight left. Three down. Mike 56. They go.
And he was that close to turning that into a big play.
It definitely puts them in better field position. And I just have a feeling that they're going to punch it into the end zone on this drive.
After a decent pickup. Gets to about the 24-yard line. Looks like he flinched down there on the line. They'll give this one another try after the flag.
And on third down, too. That's when you don't want those kind of things to happen.
Third and five now, following the defensive penalty.
Mike 56. There you
go. Get to that quickly. Touchdown, Bulldogs. He makes the PAT. Blankenship is lined up to kick this one off. Tisdale fields it at the 2. Brought down at the 30. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game.
He fights forward to about the 33. And the halfback carries for a pickup of three. Now he's scrambling. He dives and he'll be marked down. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. He's scrambling. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 48. They go with a screen here, and the halfback's got it. 3 yard loss there.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
Simmons is back deep to return the punt. They'll bring him down at the 28-yard line. They got into the end zone last time. Let's see if they can match that on this possession.
So much of the passing game is about the timing between the quarterback and his wide receiver. Right now with this offense, they are in sync, and really the timing and execution is flawless.
From their own 27-yard line, second down. Got his man. Can't tack on any yardage.
They're giving away 3 yards and only making life easier for the guys on the other side of the ball.
From their own 48-yard line, first down. They'll run it. Tackled for a loss.
I think a corner loves to have a chance to come up and make a play in the run game. So often they get labeled as just great athletes, and they just want to be involved in the passing game and being able to defend a receiver. Here, you see an attitude from this corner as he comes up, reads the play, and makes the play in the backfield.
Tackle made around the 46-yard line. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
And he's tackled right away. Great concentration to haul it in. And he's taken down at the 33-yard line. He throws it. What a play, and that'll set up a first and goal. Flags are all over the place, and they'll blow it dead.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
They're at the 7. Second down.
Mike 17.
Nice run, and he's brought down. That was a good play by the halfback. Picked up about 5 yards on the option. Finds his receiver. Touchdown. Throw for 6 gives him 4 touchdowns.
All the hard work he puts in is finally paying off. It's been rewarded here today with some pretty good throws leading to some remarkable touchdowns.
And he adds the extra point. Kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
I hope they show some fight here and try to stay competitive. If you're going to get blown out, you at least want to go down swinging.
Brought down at about the 27-yard line. Tackled at the 24.
Concentration laps right there. The coaches will be giving them an earful for it, too.
From their own 39-yard line. First down. He's tackled at about the 39-yard line. He's going to pick up less than a yard on the quarterback scramble.
Ready, three, five, three.
Tackled after a decent run up the gut. Takes a handoff, tackled for a loss.
Man, did he play that perfectly or what? As a linebacker, you have to be able to read the offense and make a quick diagnosis, which is exactly what he did on that play.
The defense has everybody on the line. I think they're going to come after this one. And he's taken down at the 31-yard line. This offense threw the ball extremely well on their last drive, and they ended up with a touchdown.
You can bet this defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the passing attack, but they need to at least be able to slow it down.
And down he goes at about the 41. One quarter to go, and we may be looking at some mop-up duty. George is running away with it. Just about set to start the fourth quarter, mercifully. Georgia in control. And they make the stop around the 42-yard line. From their own 42-yard line, it's first down. Steps up. Makes the grab, and he's knocked out of bounds. Big play right there. Now it's first and 10 after the big pass play. He makes it to the 18-yard line.
play, and he'll lose yards. Third down, 8 yards to go. Ball on the 19.
Mike 56.
Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal. He makes it to the 9. Here's the 8th play of the series.
Three down.
Georgia looking to build on this commanding lead here. He's gobbled up in the backfield. It's 3rd and goal from the 10. They'll probably look to the air here. Out to the tailback on the screen. Touchdown, Georgia! And he hits the PAT. So a 9-play, 70-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
Excellent kick. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 28. Georgia's defense has really been impressive, especially these last couple of drives.
Now you start to think about how this team has played defensively, and what it's done is set up their own offense with really good field position to give them a chance to be able to extend this lead.
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries. No one opens, so he's going to run. Tackle right around the 34. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. It's 3rd and 5. Ball on their own 34. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. They'll bring him down around the 34-yard line. Duffy is the punter. He's to the 40, and he's shoved out of bounds around the 45-yard line. The Bulldogs have been about as impressive as you can be in a football game.
Wow, this is as good as it gets. The defense is playing great. The offense has done their job. We've got a blowout here.
And here comes the offense again. They'll try to make it 2 touchdowns and 2 possessions.
I expect them to run the ball, kill the clock, and put this one in the books.
Give to the tailback. He makes it to the 45-yard line. And the halfback's got nowhere to go. From their own 45-yard line, it's 2nd down. Georgia looking to add to this big lead here. Looks for his tight end over the middle. He's taken down at the 49-yard line. That's a great tackle at the 42. From the 42-yard line, 1st down. Takes a handoff inside and stopped immediately.
Double tight, guys, double tight.
He fights forward to about the 40. And once again, they'll come to the line, try to convert on third down. And he's immediately tackled. It's first and 10. Ball on the 24-yard line. Just over a minute left. Makes it to the 8. And that's their third first down of the drive.
The defense needs to figure out a way to stop them, or else they're going to have no problem putting points on the board.
And this is the 8th play of the drive. Cook picks up about 4 yards on the play. Play number 9 of this current drive. Just a total lack of competition today.
Georgia 55, Kentucky 23.
For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.